away from the net by Hanzel. And it goes back out to neutral ice. Sammy Vatanen played that puck before he stepped on the ice, and he's going right back in the box.
That rule's been around for quite a while.
It's too many men on the ice.
Right here, Vatanen comes out. Both feet are still in the penalty box. Takes his stick and just passes him down the ice. That's a no-no.
That's another one of those momentary lapses of cerebral activity.
Benner's very tough to beat in this building. 15-4-2 at home. Oh, score! They get one! Oh, man, Yandel shot in!
That was a set play. Yandel does that, guys, every game, and it finally pays off.
I've only witnessed this one time, and it was back in the early 90s. Brent Severin. Look at the cheating goaltender. He caught him. And as you said, the cheating of Pecorini, and he picks the corner. Ha, look at the smile on his face, and the Cats are right back into this.
There's a little power outage, and the whistle goes right away. And Forsberg is really happy John Tavares didn't shoot that puck.
That does not happen very often here at the United Center. And it went real dark in a hurry, but just as quickly the lights back on.
Somebody pressed the wrong button.
Or the right button if you're a Chicago fan.
When they should be playing at their pace, which is faster for the guys in red.
The cage just about to topple over. Slap shot, score! The call on the ice is a good goal.
To me, that's a good goal. I don't think there's any question about it. Here comes the play once again. Delzato holds it from missing the Mars pegs. It gets settled, and there's the shot. I hope he gets rewarded.
Kuznetsov leans in and fires. That stopped the rebound. Karam's in. The Caps have the 3-1 lead.
And it's going to be knocked in by the hand of the defenseman. And definitely a goal because it was their own guy that put it into the net past Markstrom with his hand. And he gets the goal for Kuznetsov. Two weird goals for the Caps, but they'll take it here at home ice.
Up in the wing and deflected down at the blue line and sent in by Kane.
In front of the net, they score! Oh, how about that one? Kyle Bosso comes back with Jack Eichel, and the Buffalo Sabres have taken a 2-0 lead.
Bobrovsky and Jones have a failure to communicate.
15 teams on their break. PK in town, one of the captains of the All-Star teams.
While on top here in St. Paul, tomorrow the Vikes are in town and the crowd here is getting ready. Blake Wheeler participating as the Skull chant was taking place. Wheeler born in Plymouth.
Wide out of his hand, going to be a penalty on the chest. Oh, and then the puck back towards an empty Hawks net. Of course, he's got to hurry. He just saved a goal. That was going in. Gustav Forsling. If he doesn't have decent wheels, it would have been 1-0 for Winnipeg.
Everybody's screaming in the building after what just happened over at US Bank Stadium. The Vikings score on the last play of the game to beat the New Orleans Saints and advance to the NFC Championship game in Philadelphia next weekend. It's been a surreal atmosphere here inside the building all afternoon. The game was on in the concourse and in some of the bars here inside the building, and you'd hear a roar every time anything good happened in the football game.
Ovechkin bothered by Gallagher, and now Montreal will go a man down.
Carl Alsner actually went to the Caps penalty box.
Not surprising.
And then he quickly turned and said, wait, I'm not with the Caps anymore.
After the puck in his own zone, couldn't reach it. Bruins came in and they score. Hell of a tough one. Pasternak just shot it over at the net.
Oh, it goes off his back foot. That is so odd to see a puck actually go by the goaltender and hit that far foot and then into the net. The angle on that had to be perfect from Pasternak.
the puck and he breaks out through center. Called by himself. Look at Stone bounce off Marlin. He's trying to run over him. Instead, he just bounced off a brick wall. Presence. Henrique with a shot. Locked in front. The rebound handled by Tristan Jarry. Wrap chance. Scores! Adam Henrique!
This time, Tristan Jarry gets trapped up against the goalpost and he can't recover quickly enough. Makes a good stop on Andre Kasha. And almost looked like he lost sight of the puck for a second. Henrique with the quick wraparound.
You know, this is a cameraman coming out between periods. What the hell? He almost got caught. Oh, wait till you see the fantastic finish. Oh, over you go.
On further video review, it was determined there was goaltender interference on the play. No goal.
And Austin Matthews looking at it going, oh, really? Really, ref? Really?
Byron tripped up at the last second by Mikko Rantanen. And a penalty coming up here as Brad Meyer does some excellent work to stay with the play and make the call after getting tripped up and going down.
Yeah, he's got a little smile on his face as he pulls this off.
Jonathan Drouin trying to find room. Got a shot blocked. Rebound scores!
Quite a goal celebration by Delorier, too. He ended up on his posterior, celebrating by himself.
He's going to skate out. It's touched right here in the neutral zone. He wants to grab it. He falls down. Miller's going to skate in and save him. The last second is that's going to head right out. That would have been a wide open net.
Can't keep it in. Here's Aberg starting a 2-on-1. He's got Arvidsson with it. Aberg shot, rebound, and Domingue. He flung the stick, and he got the save somehow. How did Domingue keep it out? Now Bonino, all for Josi. Centering pass, he scores!
All right, let's look. We're going back to this first one here. We think it might have went in. Just never gives it. Oh, my goodness. That's in the net. But it didn't matter. I'm not sure if they'll go back. What an unbelievable couple of events there.
Well, here's the good news. One of these is going to count.
On an earlier play, at 10:49, the puck is back across the line. We have a good goal earlier.
Our producer, that's what he looks like after 2 days in Montreal.
Lundqvist, longest save streak is 5. Subban throws his glove and then misses the net.
See a little distraction.
Lundqvist did not even blink.
No, he didn't. He's locked in. I'm not buying that stuff right there.
Now to the gates. Picks up the puck. Oh, puts it on a stick. Tries to flip it through. Having his issues.
Good stuff from Erik Karlsson.
This was the scene in Tampa this afternoon as the pirate ships made their way into the harbor for the annual Gasparilla celebration. Fans lined the streets to enjoy the third largest parade in the United States. And the players have even gotten into the spirit. Erik Karlsson and Victor Hedman arriving in style. Night has now fallen outside Amalie Arena and the Pirates have taken over the city.
And then of course there's another hand to the face of Sidney Crosby. All in jest.
On a 2-on-1 with Jack Eichel, gives him the puck. We've seen that before, haven't we? Karlsson finishes this one.
Play is under review.
Second straight year with another challenge.
Even in an All-Star game.
Now, was Kucherov
was he on the ice or not?
He's got a foot in, maybe a foot still on the ground.
The call on the ice, it was determined that the play was offside, no goal!
That's looking very, too. Oh boy, that could get this game heated up a little bit more too, don't you think?
I think that was a challenge just so they could hear Wes McCauley make that call. And just wide.
Right in the middle. It is a goal.
If you missed it, Austin Matthews had a goal taken away last weekend. On the next shift, he scored a goal and he signaled goal, and that's just what Jack Eichel and Austin Matthews did there.
Yeah, all three of them.
DeMarchand waits, takes, scores.
And a wave to the crowd.
A pass ahead to Stamkos and up to Kucherov. Scores! Three goals on three shots.
And here comes that. The players are putting their helmets on, too.
Jack Eichel's got a string chasing him around.
Maybe he's mic'd up and it's falling apart.
No, but it's like...
Oh, I know, it's a mile long, too. Gaudreau just skated over it and cut it.
It's part of his sweater. He just realized it now and he's going off.
Attached to Gaudreau right now.
Yes.
Johnny Gaudreau got that one through against Carey Price. As Price and Mike Smith have taken over for this second period in goal.
And look at, he's all caught up when what was on the back of Eichel. Is it the sweater that just started to deteriorate or a sock? It's all over the place.
Trying to change that as Marchand crosses, tumbles down to the ice, and a penalty. The first one in the last two All-Star games.
And now the home crowd cheers him. Maybe he's trying to get 4 minutes.
Looking for a little extra mileage out of this, but I think it was more like a simple trip.
Here he goes.
And here he is. He's able to stick out along with 10 to go. He's got it. He shoots it. Wide! Icing! With 4.7 to go.
Kids were having some fun on the ice earlier. Two of his four coming together. Nixon and Axel, and they dropped the gloves.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to go at it, they said. Here we go. Let's settle the score. That is good stuff. And then third man in, he's going to get tossed out of the game for that.
And now on to Couture with the Sharks on a cash three power play. Here in the first period, taking a tumble is Josh Manson. Blew a tire, knocked the net off. That was a train wreck.
Joe moves to center and flying after him with a head attempt was connecting. He winds up in the Ottawa bench. Giroux with the puck, fires it across ice. Connecting just getting himself out of the Ottawa bench.
Yeah, it's not easy being the greatest Arizona Coyote of all time. You know, with that comes a lot of responsibilities, but I think I'll be able to.
Hank!
I apologize for that interruption, everyone. Obviously, Henrik Lundqvist wanted to say hello to me, so.
I was really bored there. There was a lot of layover time, and I figured I'd use the podiums to my advantage, and I had some fun. And even Henrik Lundqvist stopped by to say hi to me. Yeah. Humble brag.
Schaller, Kessler swoops onto it. JT Brown off Krug, and tumbles over the glass. And a Tux fan in the second row.
And they're back on it.
No touchdown!
Blocked by Duchin. He can't move it past the captain Getzlaf. Intense duck pressure. Rink wide for Rekandlin. Brooks scores! Tie game on a redirect in front by Ryan Kessler.